If you want to create sick logos for your business, this free tool from Ideogram.AI is bananas. I had to show you this tool. Let me show you a few ideas on how you can make disgustingly awesome images in just seconds. Let's check it out. So first, we're going to do a logo for my podcast business using the word Savant with podcast imagery like a microphone, headphone, etc. in the colors of blue and yellow. Let's see what we get. Let's hit generate. Let's see what we get from this software. I'll fast forward to save you a couple seconds. So we have a result. This came in. It took about 30 seconds. And let's look what we got here. So A, misspelled the word Savant, but it still gave us a little bit of inspiration on design. I hate this design. This looks dope though, right? It's like a little microphone. It's got an S next to it. It seems very balanced. This is cool piece of clip art, but it didn't follow my instructions. Here we've got an S with the headphones. So I'd say out of these four, this one is my favorite and I can continue to drill down. Let's try a different example. Let's say maybe we want to create a logo in a neon sign. Let's try this. So next we're going to ask it to create a neon sign logo for my business, Dank Taco. And I'm just going to let it run with it. Let's see what we get. And we are back and my main dog Yoda decided to join us here on screen. But let's look at these results. These look super dope, don't they? I mean, like, look at this Dank Taco logo. That looks so cool. This says Dano Takago. I don't know what that means. You can see that AI still sometimes has trouble with the English language and with letters in general. But I must say, out of all the programs that I've tried and used, these are the best. Like, this looks cool. This would be my favorite here, so we'll like this. Let's look at another example here. How about a car wash? So we're going to ask it to create a business logo for my car wash. The name of the business is Bubbles. We'll hit enter and let her rip. And I just got to say, when you start to look down, all this down here are examples of art that other people have made just using words. And so what you can actually look at here is what are the ones that I like and what are people actually typing in? Look, we actually got on the trending list with our Dank Taco sign. And so you can get a little bit of inspiration. You can look at the types of words like, you can words like vintage, all white line drawing. Like that is pretty cool. Lord of the Wings. And you can see it still has that, the problem that a lot of these things have. Movie poster for Lord of the Wings, a Lord of the Rings parody where every famous character is just a chicken. Also say it's Oscar nominated. You gotta love the internet. That's hilarious. So anyway, you can get some inspiration from the images down here. This grizzly is super cool. Snow ink drawing vanishing point. So you can use like different styles like Andy Warhol or Rockefeller or ink drawing or psychedelic pop art. So there's all sorts of different styles you can use to get it done. And the results are in. Kind of cool car wash. This is really cool here. Bubbles, it's got the bubbles, it's got the car there. This one doesn't work for me because, again, you keep seeing this over and over. The words are not always spot on, but this one is definitely my favorite here. Bubbles. Oh, no, but it added another B, so that's not a winner either. So we kind of had a little bit of fail on the word bubbles. Now, one of the things you could do is, let's say you like this particular item. We could upload it to a program like Canva. We could send it to a graphic designer. We could send it to a designer at an agency like mine. I run a podcast agency. We help you turn a podcast into a powerful tool. We help you to automate it. And we do a lot of the design work behind the scenes. So we could take like a design or an idea that you create in a program like Ideogram, and we could kind of elevate it and bring it to the next level. But this is another interesting. Let's look at another design here as well as Yoda sits here for inspiration. Let's look at another design for a potential business. So we're going to go with create a logo for my personal brand. The brand name is Fox. Include an image of a fox. Let's generate. Let's see what we got, baby. So as we see here, as it is finishing generating, it's not actually including the word fox. It's got some cool images of fox, but I want the word too. So let's go ahead and dismiss that. And let's try to be a little bit more specific with what we want from the AI program here. So we're going to ask it to include the word fox and include an image of a fox. Let's go ahead and generate. I just want to say, as I'm kind of walking down here, looking at some of these images, I'm seeing some really cool ones. Like, look at this logo, Walk to Healed. And there's a dog here. The dog has a second tail, which is kind of weird, which again, you might want to have an agency on the back end to kind of help with the cleaning up. This is super cool though. Capture the moments. Crush Roulette. Look at that. That is pretty interesting looking. That's pretty slick. We could also do things like removing the background, changing colors. There's different things we can do. AI is a really powerful, I think, inspiration tool. And every once in a while you get lucky and it'll give you a really, really great final. Look at this. The Usos logo. That's pretty cool. Again, I'm really focusing on logos here in this video and what I'm looking for. Herbal tea. Wow, that looks sick. It's a little bit complex for a logo. Look at this one. And you know, so when I look here, it says minimalist logo design of the letters EA shaped like an apple. I'm going to use this prompt, minimalist, and I'm going to actually like it. I'm going to show them some love. But I'm going to use this prompt of minimalist and see if we can do something cool using the initials of my business company, Mark Savant Media. Let's see. Our results are in for the fox. It did not include the word fox. It gave me your ox retain. Weird. I do like this clip art though. And again, another thing we could do is we could just say, hey, we really like this piece of custom AI generated clip art. We'll take that and we'll do something with it. This is kind of interesting too. Create almost like turning the fox into the word itself. There might be something interesting that we could do with that when we get it to our graphic designer. So anyway, you could start to see how some of these ideas and tools could be really cool. But let's use that word minimalist to see if we can do something cool as well. Let's see if we can do something neat there. So I'm going to use this prompt engineer of minimalist logo design of the letters MSM. And you know what? I'm going to start without this podcast imagery part because that is, I think, very vague. So let's start with minimalist logo design letters MSM. And let's see what we get. And then we might try to add on top of that some additional prompts. So let's start with this and let's see what we get. And the results are in, and we've got some pretty interesting designs here. I'm not exactly sure what's going on here, but it's kind of interesting. It kind of reminds me of like a tent and an M at the same time. Are there multiple M's there? I don't know. This is kind of interesting. Not quite there. This one is probably my favorite M, but I'm struggling to get the S here. It's just not quite there for me. This is interesting. Like they're all interesting. And I think that's a big takeaway is we can get a lot of inspiration from these ideas. And this is a big part of what we do here at Mark Savant Media when we're producing podcasts, when we're producing show art and designs. We can draw upon this inspiration to create really dope images. I have some amazing graphic designers on my team here. So anyway, if you're kind of working through these things, you can always hit me and my team up to see how we can elevate your podcast and your program. Let's go a little bit deeper here though. Minimalist logo of the letters MSM, but let's add a little bit here. Maybe add some imagery. So we're going to ask it to add headphones and a mic because I have a podcast agency. I help thought leaders launch and automate podcast. Let's see if we can go with this minimalist logo while also adding a little bit of design and a little bit of imagery to it. Let's see what we get here. Lynn, we're just playing. We're looking at different things. Oh, that's a cute little cat. All right, I'll see you in a minute. Okay, and we have some images here. It took about 30 seconds. These are really cool. Like, I kind of like this here. These almost look like microphones. This S, I don't dig the little dink at the end, but it's pretty interesting. I like the symmetry. I think symmetry in logos is important. I really like this one too. It's missing the S, but maybe there's a way that we could incorporate that into our final logo design, but very interesting. Now, I want to show you something else that's cool. Hey, we're going to like this, but if we look at this, we can actually remix it. Okay, and what that means is we pick out our favorite logo out of the four, and we're just going to ask it to remix it. And again, what that's going to do is just go a level deeper and maybe iterate on our favorite idea just a little bit more. Let's see what our results are. So we've got the results from our remix in, and to me, it hasn't really elevated. This is a slightly interesting take on it. Here you've got some like cables. I also like that there's actually a headphone in the middle. So again, it's another elevation of the initial, but you know, I think we're taking steps backwards by adding. I want to show you one more example of something cool that we can do here and create. And this time we're not going to create a minimalist logo. We're going to create a logo using the letters MSM, add headphones and a mic. But we're going to do this in 3D and let's see what we get. So 3D logo of the letters. We could also do, we hit this little 3D render button. You can see that there's different styles that you can choose here just to make it a little bit easier. So we're going to do 3D. Let's do vibrant 3D. And let's see what we get here. Let's hit the generate button and see what pops off. And we've got a result here and whoa, look at these. These are awesome. Holy cow. These are super. I got to like both of these. Now, look, this is going to be too complex for a logo. You're not going to be able to easily add this to a shirt or a hat or anything like that. But whoa, these are super freaking dope. I just hope that you get in here and start playing with this app. AI is here. It's changing the world. I'm going to be covering all the newest stuff. If you like this video, like and comment below. And if you're looking to elevate your own logos and your own podcast, I'm the guy, Mark at MarkSavantMedia.com. Hit me up. I'll catch you in the next video. Peace.